Hi guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I will be teaching you how to make use of Filmmaker app to edit your videos. So if you are a beginner or someone who wants to edit any kind of video, whether your Instagram videos, any type of video, you can also make use of Filmmaker app, and it's best, it's user friendly, and it's also good. So guys, come along and watch how I use this app that look like this. Is has the color black and gold color, so that's how it looks like. You can see it under a Filmmaker app, and it's good. So guys, come along and watch. So guys, once you open your Filmmaker app, it will show you this way. If you have an edit you haven't finished, it will continue from there when you click on yes. But if you want to start afresh, just click on not now. And for the sake of this video, I will be starting with new project. So I'll be clicking on new project so you guys can see how to start from the beginning to the end. So this is the blank page of the Filmmaker app. And this app is good for editing all kinds of videos, for any activities you want to use it for. So start here is where I will import all my videos from. So I'll click on it. It will show me this area where I have all videos, photo, intros and poster. If you don't have an intro, you can easily click on this intro here and choose from all the inbuilt intro they have on the app. The ones that have pro are the ones you have to pay for when you pay for the app. So you get them free as long as you are paying for the app. But if you haven't paid for the app, you can't use them. You rather use the ones that are already there. So guys, let's edit the video. So I'm clicking directly on videos, and I'll select my video. So I have this two clip I will be using for the sake of this tutorial. So I'm importing it down to the editing page. Now I will reduce the volume of the video so you guys can hear my voice and also the voice of what I'm editing, so you can get what I'm trying to do. So this is how to remove or trim, split, cut, duplicate and reduce the volume of the video. So guys, I will be clicking on the speaker like button. So the video is 100%.
Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel.
So I will be reducing it to, let's say,
to you guys, secret.
So it won't be louder than my voice. So yeah, I'll click OK by clicking on this max sign at the end.
Hope you guys will be interested in this topic because we are on lockdown, and I know it's a trying time for many entrepreneurs. So guys,
yes, so I have the video as this. As you can see, the video is unedited. It's starting from where I moved in to when I started talking. So to remove those areas, I will have to trim. Yep. So first thing, you just have to listen to the video so you don't make mistakes.
Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel.
So after listening to it, you can pause, then you trim from the beginning to the end, so you don't have to cut where it's necessary. So you just have to watch the video, listen to it, then look at the areas where you have to trim before you cut or trim any part from it. So I've done that. As you can see, I've removed that area. If I want to move back, I'll click on this arrow here, but I don't want to because I think it's okay this way. Now there's a white stripe showing in front of the video, probably because of where I place my camera, so that's why that line is showing. But it won't be good to bring out this video in that way. So I will be cropping the video. So this is the button for crop. As you can see, you just have to drag. That's all you have to do. The exact point where you think it will be suitable, and that white line won't be showing. I think it's okay like this. And I left it at original. I didn't remove it from original simply because I wanted to stay up the original video size and shape I used in videoing it, should in case someone is looking, watching the video using the portrait front of the camera or the landscape or the the landscape side. So depending on whatever size they're using, it will still be bold and clear for them to watch through. So that's why I'm leaving it at original. But so in case you want to resize it for whatever sake you have, there are various sizes you can reshape it into. So for the sake of this video, I will be leaving it that way. So I'll click on OK again to make sure that you can see my code, that part away, and the video is looking a little bit balanced and cute. I will also be reducing the volume so it's not louder than my voice. That's the first thing. Then now, if you listen to it, you notice that this is the beginning part. That's the first segment, and the second segment is the ending part. So I will also be trimming it to the particular place where I walked in and sat down and started talking. So I'll be trimming it to that point like this, and I'll be trimming the end to the point where I stood up. So I stood up after saying bye. So I think it's okay this way, and I click on okay, and it will load down to the page. So guys, I'm done editing the video. See, it's very simple and easy. So now if I want to add music to the background of my video, I have options of music, sound effects, voice over, extract music from video, my music, depending on what you want. So for the sake of this video, I want to add sound effects to the background, or music. Let's just put music to the background because I don't really need a sound. Suppose I'm writing a text, and to bring people's attention, I can use sound effect. But for the sake of this video, let me just add music. Now I have varieties of options to choose from under my music. I have the vlog type, the dynamic, cheerful, pop, depending on the ones you want. So I'm choosing from the vlog type. I think I'm cool with the music here. So these songs here are free, are copyright free. So before you use them, you can just click on them, listen to it, then you download. So the ones that have the sign arrow going down are the ones I haven't downloaded, and the ones I have downloaded are the ones that have the plus sign in the circle. So I love using the ones that doesn't have. Reduce the volume of the song so that it won't be louder than your voice. I think it's okay this way. I'll click on okay. Now, because this is where my arrow was when I click on the music button, that is why the song started from that place. So I will be moving my arrow to the beginning of the video, so I will be moving the song too. I'll click on it, then it will come in this shape and form. So I'll use my hand to move it. You can see this app is so easy and easy to use. It's user friendly. Just play along and enjoy using it. You can see that's it. So if I should play, you can see as I'm talking, my song is also playing at the background and it's not disturbing the video. So guys, anytime you see me smiling, you can see the song is also playing in the background, so rhyming. So guys, the next thing is that if you watch the video at the end and the music is still long, like it's way above the video, so you just have to click on the music again and trim by just moving it. Oh god, it has gone beyond the video again, so I just have to click on this arrow and re-edit the video again. But this time around, I'll be moving it a little bit to the front, a little bit like that. So to know if it has is enough or not, I think I still have to move it again. Oh, I still have to move it again. This time I'll probably a little bit. Okay, I'm moving closer. I think it's okay this way. Okay, I think it's okay. Yeah, it's okay. So the next thing is for me to add text. Sorry guys, this orange stuff is a screen recorder. Now this is my text. I'll double tap to edit whatever I want to write. I just have to double tap and add it. Let me say success video tip, because this video is all about tips. So when I'm done, I click on the sign. I have it this way. Now I can choose the size, font, anything I want. I think this is best. Now I click on OK. It will bring me to this segment to add color, so I can choose whatever color I want and I can put it in a box like this, and I can move it to the side wherever I want it to be, and I click on OK. So you see it at the side of the video and it will pop out when it gets to this segment. So guys, Filmmaker is easy and friendly to use. Now the next tool I have here is the sticker tool, or call it the emoji tool, whatever tool you want to call it, but it has a smiley face here as the logo. Now it is where you get the subscribe button, the likes, your Instagram image, your Facebook image, whatever fonts you want. We have the offline, we have the gold, we have different kind of fonts you can play around with. The ones that have pro are the ones you get only after paying for the app, and the ones that are free are the ones that doesn't have pro, but you still have to download them to be able to make use of them. So guys, there are lots more. So if you don't want any of these, probably you want to add your own image, you can click on this image button here to bring it down to your photos, and it will ask you to select whatever image you want to put. So let's say I want to add this beauty. So after clicking on OK, you'll see the image on your screen. So that's it. Yeah, I have the image on my screen that way. So the next thing for you is to save. Yep, so you click on the save icon here, You choose whatever size, resolution, quality you want. The best quality is usually medium and high. So you choose from whichever quality you want and the size. If the video is too large, you can reduce it to 480p. But I don't like using the 360p, but it's also good depending on the video you're creating. So this is how I love using my app. I prefer it being the medium size, 480p and the 720p. So that's it. Then I export. So it asks me save as a new project or save to original project. I will choose to save as a new project to make all the errors I've corrected and everything to be in a proper order. So click that and you see it load, then bring it down to the area where you see it's counting to save and to tell you do not lock screen or switch to any other app till it's done. So just be patient, the video is exporting, so just be patient and it will save directly to the place you will love it to be on your storage device or wherever. So be patient with it and afterwards you can now watch the video to know if it was done properly before you post it down to wherever you want, that your YouTube or your Instagram, wherever you want to post the video. So guys, that is all for using this Filmmaker app.